just in case you ain't know. I'm
on defense.
You turn me up in them headphones.
I'm 5 hours to the low. Whoa.
It ain't even fair. I mean, real rap.
That boy cap in his raps.
Woo!
He got no cash.
No cash.
Old pillow talking ass fuck nigga got no cash.
No cash.
You surround yourself with some real niggas, but you still a bitch.
You still a bitch.
You ain't drop shit.
Ain't drop shit.
Never kill shit. Ain't nothing to invade.
Bang.
Come through, make house calls. Start passing out bulletins.
Wow.
Got me feeling like pulling.
Pullin'.
Finally ride, I get to it.
Do
I'm mopped up, though we stupid.
Hey, let's shout out to the man, man.
Fuck you, nigga.
What's up, man?
Fuck you, nigga. I'm a real blood, nigga.
You're not good out
fuck
here,
you,
boy.
Nigga.
Not fuck good you, out
nigga.
Here,
boy. Fuck you, nigga. Oh, hold on. I got a song with Davies, bitch.
Wow. That's interesting.
Y'all know what it is. I'm locked in with my boy Joe Bunny, nigga. Hey, turn up on your video shoot, my boy.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Hey!
These rap shit is easy.
Hey!
Telling you.
Yeah.
YouTube, man. Blessings to everybody, man. Good morning. This is another segment of Wake and Bake in the AM when I'm him, Giovanni. This is another banger of Smoking Politics with me, episode 17. Like, comment, subscribe. Hit that notification bell, man. Share this, comment, like, dislike, troll in the comments. As long as you're watching this whole video until its entirety, I will really appreciate that, and I'll be grateful for that. Thank you very much. Shout out to all my 239 subscribers and counting. I appreciate each and every single one of y'all. And to the rest to the rest of the world, I hope you guys have a blessed morning. Have a blessed day. Remain sucker free. Stay productive. And separate yourself from those who do not deserve your energy. And that includes family. Everybody grab your raw papers, your backwoods, your vapes, your bongs, your pipes, whatever's your pleasure. And come and smoke a politic with me, man. It's another segment of Wake and Bake in the AM with your boy, I'm him, Giovanni, man. Another banger of Smoking Politic with me. Episode 17, man. Let's get this rolling. Now, as you guys seen in the clip, right, in the beginning, right, Meek Worldwide Weirdo at it again. And what did I say in episode 15? I said in episode 15, dudes are not going to care. They're still going to stand next to dudes that have rape and snitching allegations on their jacket. You know what I'm saying? An innocent man doesn't run. I don't care what the situation is. I don't care about nothing. 9 times out of 10, I'm sure there's cases of innocent people running because they're scared. But it's rare that you hear that. But allegations like these, it's not like that weirdo it's not like he's a regular dude. You know what I mean? He's not. I hate to say it, he's not a regular dude. He got a bag, he got a name, he got clout, and he's famous. He's usually, you know what I mean? His face is well recognized. So for him, knowing all this, why would he run with allegations like that, that are being thrown his way? He's supposed to, like I said in episode 15, he was supposed to attack that. And he did, but he did it all comic-like. He was playing with it. Like, it wasn't serious. Like, you know what I mean? It's like... But the thing that sticks out more than that is that you ran, Pop. Worldwide Weirdo, you ran. Why is you running if you're not? Why did you have them come search for you, put out warrants for you, and you were seeing it and you were still on the run? Why is you running for? Because you're guilty, and I know you are. You know what I mean? There was a video surfacing of underage girls being uncomfortable around you. A girl in a red shirt, you could see it. Her face, you could just tell that she was young. And she was uncomfortable, and you was all over that. And you knew she was young. I don't want to hear none of that. He's a weirdo. And now, to these dudes. These dudes. Homeboy, listen, disclaimer. Side note, I do not gangbang. I never have. I never will. Obviously, I'm finna be 37. It's a little bit too late, right? But that ain't never been my cup of tea. To each his own, man. I know plenty of people that wave different color flags. You know what I mean? But this dude threw up the pitchfork. He threw up the pitchfork and he's screaming blood. Make it make sense, for one. And for two, you're screaming out, I did a song with Dave East, nigga! I hope Dave East sees this and he don't clear that song. You know what I mean? Because now he ain't never gonna do another song with you because you standing next to a known weirdo. You know what I mean? A known weirdo that ran from the allegations. He ain't even stand on his own two to face it head on when it first came to his way. He ran. They had to go get him. They had to send out flyers all over the world that he was wanted for that. And he was still on the run. And they went and arrested him. And you standing next to that. A lot of those dudes in that video, look like they ain't even take a shower that day. You know what I mean? Probably in a couple days. You know what I mean? But you are the company you keep. A lot of them dudes are probably messing with underage girls. So they overlooking that. It's normal to them. You know what I mean? Those are the type of dudes that give Atlanta a bad rap. You know what I mean? It's just weird. It's weird as hell. You know what I'm saying? Like I said in episode 15. For clout, people are going to... and money and to gain off motherfuckers... People are going to stand next to whatever. Nick, people will stand next to a pile of shit if that pile of shit could talk and breathe and talk and had money and was giving out money. People would stand next to a pile of shit. For real, right? I'm convinced. Looking for the rat snitch nine situation. You got dudes that are in the hood, supposedly street dudes, honorable young boys, right? They went against everything they stood for, right? To stand next to a rat. Because he's giving them money. One of them said, we don't jack rats. He's the only rat we jacking. He sound foolish. Dizzy. I blame his daddy. Real rap. We all started from the sack. Where's your mind at, young boy? You know what I mean? Now when Snitch 9, you know I'm going off topic, but I'm going to get off him real quick. But I have to make a point. Now when Snitch 9 is done with these dudes, they're going to go back to the hood. And they're going to have to hide. You know what I mean? For the rest of their life until they leave New York. If they leave New York. If they got a bag to even leave the hood. Which I highly doubt it. Because they had a bag while they run around next to a rat. For a bag. Make it make sense. Now back to this weirdo. Worldwide weirdo. I just said it in episode 15. People are still going to rock with him. Some people because it's clout. He has clout. He has money. If he was Miko, worldwide weirdo, working at Burger King with these same allegations... People would disown this dude. People would probably do him dirty. Or maybe not. Because look at. Look what goes on in the hood. Look at this shit right here. He's throwing up the rakes and he's screaming blood. Weirdo. You know what I mean? I guarantee you out of all them dudes in that video. Maybe one of them took a shower that day and brushed their tongue and teeth. And flossed. Maybe one of them. And I guarantee you like four of them. Either have done it or doing it right now as we speak, messing with an underage girl. Real red. You know what I mean? Yeah. I would put money on that. Yo, man, these are the people, man. These are the people y'all choose to subscribe to and hit that bell and make famous, man. And it's crazy. It's crazy. You know what I mean? And they're calling out China Mac. Like, come on, man. I'm sure he's laughing at that, bro. What, your first video, it didn't do it, right? People didn't want to be on camera, right? Now you had to go on camera because you had probably had to drop a little bag over there. You know what I'm saying? But why is they around you still? Even if they felt like, hold, if they didn't know for sure, they shouldn't be around you if they call themselves honorable street dudes, right? If they call themselves with the business, right? You know what I mean? It's just dudes going against their morals just to stand next to somebody that has a name, a bag, and clout. So they think they're going to be able to build off that. It's just milk mentality. It's just weirdo mentality. It's just broke mentality. These dudes, this right here is going to be the most clout and they ever got. Right there. This right here. I'm sure other people, other bloggers are going to be sharing this and other news outlets on YouTube are going to be sharing the same video. This is the most clout these dudes are going to ever have in their life. Nobody is going to rock with these dudes. Look at who you standing next to. I don't want to KO. No. An innocent man doesn't run. An innocent man doesn't run. Everybody, let's take a break real quick. Like your raw papers, your backwoods, you know what I'm saying? Your entourages, my people on Philly, whatever, man. Your vapes, your pipes, your bongs. Whatever's your pleasure, man. Come smoke a pile, take with me. Everybody hit that like, subscribe, hit the bell. I won't disappoint. This is raw, uncut, honorable, and sturdy content, man. Another segment, Awaken Bacon the AM with your boy, I'm him, Giovanni. Another banger of Smoking Politic with me, man. Episode 17, man. Be on the lookout for next month, Eating Politic with me, another segment. And Smoking Politic with me, Hood Vlogs, man. Y'all really going to see my talent, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. But back to this, man, because I'm not going to touch on this for too long, man. This is not going to be one of my normal segments that's 15 minutes or better. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, man, they just proved everything right, what I said in my episode 15. Check that out, man. Miko, Worldwide Weirdo, tells China Mac to pull up. And I'm also talking about the Milk Trolls, too. Milk 7-4 Trolls, too. Well, Milk Trolls. Yeah, so... Yeah, man, that's right there what you just saw. That's just what it is, man. That's what put this back in the day, early 2000s, and before that, none of this would be going on. Like I feel like life in general and the industry was more realer. It had at least a little bit more honor, and people were held accountable and for their discretions and the shit that said that came out their mouth. You know what I'm saying? Like. It's just crazy, man. Like, these dudes, these new dudes, these late 90s, not all of them, but like I said, you know, certain groups of people give a bad name to their group of people. Like, the point I'm trying to make is some of these late 90s babies and early 2000 babies are so dizzy, and they give a bad rep for the rest of ones, man. Like, because not all late 90s baby and early 2000 babies going to stand next to a pedophile and a rat. They don't even care if they got a bag or a name or, you know what I mean, or clout. They're not going to do that. They're not going to go against their morals because they were raised better than that. And they sturdy. You know what I mean? Then you got these dudes like that. Guarantee you a lot of them from the late 90s and early 2000s. You know what I mean? Stanking. They look dirty as hell. Just dirty. Fingernails all dirty. Everything just dirty. Like, niggas ain't even shower or brush their tongue or floss or brush their teeth. I bet you they got mad earwax pulled out of their ears and shit. Like... It's just weird. But you know what? You are the company you keep. Now, I'ma just call it out. Every time I see this dude, Worldwide Weirdo, on camera with a bunch of dudes, you are the company you keep. You're a weirdo, too. You condone that, too. You probably like little boys and little girls, too. You probably on the low messing with cross-dressers, too. You know what I mean? Like, you are the company you keep. How are you condoning that? How are you dudes condoning that? And Paul, I did a song with David East. That needs to be a meme. How are you throwing up the rakes, but you screaming out blood? Last time I checked, and I'm not a banger. Last time I checked, the GD's banging the six. The Bloods, they bang the five. Make it make sense. Make it make sense. So dirty ass. You look like the stinkiest and mustiest out of all of them. You know what I mean? I did a song with Dave East. Let's see if you can come back up here again to New York and do a song with Dave East. Weirdo. You know what I mean? Weirdo. Shout out to all my real people down in the A, too. In and out in Henry, Georgia, too, where the Atlanta Motor Speedway is, man. People be sleeping on Henry, Georgia, man. It goes down in the country over there, man. You know what I mean? I used to live out there in Henry, Georgia, and I used to work at a Dairy Queen. This is back in 2004. And I used to have to walk like a damn mile and a half to Dairy Queen getting paid $5.25, man. That's just that's another story, man. But yeah, man, shout out to them real people down there. It's sad that you got individuals like that, clout demons like that, dirty bums, dirty and confused weirdos, you know what I mean? They don't know what they want to bang. They want to bang the six or the five. They throwing up rakes or they blood, like, you know what I mean? Standing next to a known pedophile. I don't care. Innocent man don't run. Innocent man don't run. Let anybody put allegations on me, woman or child or another man, put allegations on me like that, I'm going to the police station. You know what I mean? And I'm going to, and I will put literally try to put my hands on them people in front of the police. That's what innocent people will try to do. I know I will go crazy. I can't speak for anybody else. Innocent people don't run. These dudes are clout demons. These dudes ain't going nowhere in life. I hate to say that and be negative and put out negative energy like that. You know what I mean? Because I wish the best for everybody. But individuals like that, there's only two things for them. Death and freaking death. Because they're just weird. They move all sloppy. You know what I mean? You can just tell. Like, it's just the little things. Look at what you're standing next to. Even if there's a little chance. And I don't think there's no chance. But let's just, you know what I mean? I don't want to be too biased. Because this is non-biased contact, right? But I just feel like this bro, this dude, if you, he ran. He ran. He should have, innocent people don't run. But anyway, the point I'm trying to make, anybody that got a jacket, like any allegations like that, if it's true or not, you're not going to stand next to no real solid dude or woman is going to stand next to that person until they know the truth about it. Only a clout demon and people that are just disgusted morally and that probably do that and condone that on the con behind closed door are going to be cool with shit like that. You know what I mean? And these effects. I'm going to get up out of here, man. This has been another segment, Awake and Bake in the AM, with your boy, I'm Him, Giovanni. Another banger of Smoking Politic with me, episode 17. You know what I'm saying? Like, comment, subscribe, hit that bell, troll, dislike. As long as we're engaging in the comments, you know what I'm saying? Once again, I want to say blessings to everybody. I hope y'all have a blessed day. Keep cool. Stay hydrated. Remain sucker free. Stay productive. We all have the same 24 hours. Even if you've been grinding for all these days and you're having to lay down, you got your smartphone, you can still network and do your thing as you're chilling. See, that's remaining and staying productive, right? Yeah, we all have the same 24 hours. There's no excuses. You shouldn't be out there hating on the next man, woman, or child that's doing their thing. You know what I mean? There's no excuse. And separate yourself from those who do not deserve your energy. And that includes family. And let me get one more hit for y'all. Peace.
Big stacking, hold up. Be exotic in my paper roller. Never catch me lacking, bitch. I'm pulled up. I'm about that action, sipping cold.